So that's a pretty much cut, dry, clear, and simple. You know, to break anything down. He doesn't want us associating ourselves, hanging out with folks who are wicked, ungodly, and do not even acknowledge God as God. You hang around with folks, you're going to have a headache at the end of the day. That's my mind. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. That means you and I, as Christians, we should be thinking about the Word of God all during the day. Like, how do I please God? Your number one objective should be pleasing God. That should be on the thing to do list. Number one, please God, serve God. Number two, buy real estate. That's a family joke right there. And number three, four, and five. Well, number three would be going on a cruise. So, yeah. I know all y'all now.
It's the cheapest way to take a vacation. And make money and be sending rich shit.
Right, so, but keeping everything back in proper perspective, that should be the number three on your thing to do it. How I please God, and if you're concerned yourself with how I please and how you're going to please God, everything else, God's just going to lay it in your lap, you know. But however, pleasing God, we also have to serve God, you know. The only way you can serve God is you got to know his will and his game plan, his all-around plan for earth. Now, if you were to ask me, Mike, what's the Bible about? I'm going to tell you, the Bible is about the redemption of man. So we have to know that the Word of God is about the redemption of man to please God, you know. All the other stuff is on the deep end of theological pool, like world of what? That's the deep end of theological pool. You know, great election, well, grace is pretty essential to Christ. But election, when you go into the subject of election, you can go into the deep end of theological pool. Because you've got different perspectives on election. If you talk to a guy with a master's degree in divinity, he's going to give you the description of election that's not even lining up. So they turn everything into salvation, you know. And election is far bigger than salvation, you know. Just like free will, you get in that subject and you're going to have a headache because there's different perspectives on free will. How much free will does man have? Does God know every single thing you're going to do? Some people say he knows everything you're going to do, you know. So did he know when I woke this morning I was going to, you know, scratch my nose and put my finger in my ear? I don't think he knew that. I don't think he even cared about that. So this is the question of, and when you get to those areas, that's the deep theological pool. We can argue about that all day long. Okay, let's go back to Psalm 1. Psalm 3, the one in Psalms, Psalm 3 is the verse we need to underline. And it says, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bringeth forth his fruit in his season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. So what was the requirements for all this to happen? It was what? To delight in his law and to meditate on God day and night. Right. If you're meditating on God day and night, he's going to plant you like a firm tree. You know, and your leaves are not going to wither. Okay? And that's a pretty good lesson. Let's see. Here we go. Here's something for the ungodly. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind driveth away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knoweth the ways of the righteous, but the ways of the ungodly shall perish. Right? You can bet your last dollar on that. If a person has decided that they want to mock God, they want to believe in God, they want to laugh at God, because right now Christians are under fire because we're not going along with their new lifestyle rules. Which, I tell you, you know, don't get distracted about that. Satan's always trying to do something to distract you. You just got to stay focused on Scripture. Don't worry about what you're going to do. You can't do anything about it. So if you sit up, four or five hours running, how could they do that? You could be reading the Bible. Meditating on God. Think about the Lord Jesus. Trying to figure out how you can be a good witness to somebody. Trying to say to myself, how can I get to myself to a point where God can use me want to get yourself to that point. However, don't cast your brother for swine. I'm not going to sit and try to convince the atheistic convention of society that they need to come on my side. This word is too precious for their ears. And they probably read the Bible already and don't believe it.
Don't think they haven't read the Bible. They've read the Bible.
They just don't believe the Bible. Okay? So, when we take a look at Psalm 1, I think the best verse that everybody should remember is Psalm 1, verse 3. I would underline that, you know, and say this is like, if you meet the condition of Psalm 1, verse 2, you get the reward of Psalm 1, verse 3. You understand what I'm saying? You know, the condition in Psalm 1, verse 2 is, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law does he meditate day and night. Okay? So you are the law, his covenant, you are delighted in studying it, and you're meditating on his word. So if you do that, you get the reward of Psalm 1, verse 3, and he shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that bring forth his fruit in season. His leaf also shall not wither, and whatsoever he does shall prosper. That means whatsoever he does shall prosper. That's a strong promise right there, you know. You know, that means a lot of people can't get their life together. They don't make love the Lord, but they don't meditate on God's word. The word of God is not a priority for them. It might be secondary or third. God don't want to be second. God don't want to be second. He wants to be third. He wants to be number one. Because God is absolute. He's the number one Uno. You know, God was always God. You know, we can't do nothing for God. We can't add nothing to his character or nothing to who he is. Okay, so God himself was this thing, he was always here. Okay, here we go.
I'm sorry. I said that.
Oh, that's okay. We're going to edit the video.